Hopefully I can get this thing to work better than the last time. Hey everyone that's here. Hello, hello, hello. Welcome. Happy Friday to everyone. Last time I had nothing but problems, so let's hope it goes better this time. Hey Kathleen, hey Robin, hey Liz. Hey Michelle, hi Tony, hey Nanette and Karen, how are you guys doing? Hey Stacy, thanks everyone for coming in and joining. It's such a treat to hang out with you guys. I changed my browser, so I'm hoping that it's going to work better than the last time. Because yeah, last time you guys probably remember was a disaster and I couldn't get like any mods going on or anything. Hi Shayna. Hi Heather. Yeah, it has been a while, Nanette. Hey Mona. Mona, it looks like you're automatically a mod. I tried to set this up earlier today, so hopefully it's in there. I don't know. Last time, I think it was my browser. I think I was using Internet Explorer, and it was either the fact that I couldn't use that anymore, or I don't know, or maybe there was just too many people, so I don't know, but it looks like it's okay right now, so let's see. We shall see. So how are you guys doing tonight? Oh, I'll definitely take you up on that, Robin. Thank you. Hopefully I can do it. Let's see. Okay, it looks like it worked, so thank you so much. Hey, JoJo. Hi, Rebel on Wheels Reviews. How are you doing? Hi, Sahara. Hey, Pickle, how you doing? I don't know if you've ever been in one of my streams, have you? Okay, well, I'll be here talking about nonsense, I'm sure, so you won't miss too much, Mona, that's for sure. Now, I was looking at this thing before, and it was telling me that I could, like do stuff, but now I don't know how to do stuff. It gave me some sort of way that I could go into my video and stuff before, now I don't know how to do it. Dang it. Why do I always come up so late? Let's see. Nope, that's not what I'm gonna do. Well, anyway, it's working, so I'm gonna be happy with that. Okay. Just give me a minute, guys. Just getting this thing moving here. I'm hoping it looks like everything's going well. Maybe it was in this. Just give me a second, guys. I'm just trying to look to see how I did that earlier today. I was in there and I was able to go in and like do all kinds of stuff, but now I don't know how I did it. So forget it. I'm just gonna do this the way I usually do it and get back to it. Anyway, okay. Oh my gosh, it's midnight for you, Pickle. It's so late. Well, thanks for coming in. Hi, Pamela. I know, I am. Oh, Colorful Cat Lady. Yes, okay. I remember that name. Hey, Charlotte, Nellie, and Mona again. And is that it? Did I get everyone? Robin, don't kick out Chainsaw 581. That's my husband, so. So, I hope you guys are all doing good. I'm going to give it a few minutes to see if anybody else is going to join. Honestly, I knew I was going to do this, and then I completely forgot that I was going to do this, and I didn't advertise or anything like that. So, you probably will hear my son and my husband in the background there because I have the door open. If it gets too loud, I'll shut it. But, yeah, so if anybody else wants to mod, I could take like two more mods if you want to. If you don't, you just want to hang out in color, that's okay. But I thank you in advance if anyone wants to volunteer. So we're going to be doing a Harry Potter color along this weekend. Starts today, goes all weekend. And I was going to color something from, oh gosh, what's her name? Fabiana Attanasio. For those of you guys that don't know, if you look on her Etsy shop, she has a few, like, I think she has a Harry Potter packet that you can print out and color along with. Okay, Mona, I'll take it. Thank you. And I was going to do one of those. I was going to do Harry. But then I saw that everybody was doing those. So, you know me. I don't want to do that anymore. So, I actually bought this little book. I didn't know what to expect from it. I just looked it up on Amazon for Harry Potter coloring books. And the other ones that they have, you know, like the movie ones, they were just too busy for me. And I just know I'm never going to get much done. So I figured, let me order this and see if it's a disaster. If it is, then we won't do anything. I'll just go back to what I was going to do. But it's actually really cute. So we'll do a little flip through of it and we'll probably get not too much coloring done. But, you know, it's what it is. So what's everyone coloring tonight? Are you coloring Harry Potter? Are you watching Harry Potter? Are you listening to Harry Potter? I know there's a little controversy going on with Harry Potter right now, but I'm not all up in that. I can separate the artist from the work and I'm good with it. So it's okay with me. Hey, Zilly, good to see you. Oh, Shayna says, this is such an awesome color that I love Harry Potter. I was going to color one of those too, but decided on a Fantastic Beasts picture. Oh, that's a good one too. Yeah, I hate to admit it, but I've never seen Fantastic Beasts. Oh, Pickle's coloring Pocahontas. Yep, let's try that again. Pocahontas. And Nellie's coloring Hermione from the Harry Potter Magical Places and Characters. Fantastic Beasts is amazing. I need to see it. I haven't read the book either, so. Oh, you're coloring Dobby, Michelle. That one is so cute. That was actually what I was going to do. I was going to buy Dobby and color that because I already have Harry. But I'm a huge Dobby fan, and we actually call our little dachshund Snow White, we call her Dobby, because she has really big ears, and they go inside out all the time. And when we first got her, she used to carry socks around. Like, all the time she was rooting through Frank's dirty laundry, and she'd come running out with his socks. So we always called her Dobby, and we still do sometimes. And she had this little tiny stuffed Dobby that she played with. It was like her favorite toy, but she ripped it to pieces. So I don't think we have it anymore. But I just decided we're actually going to do a Dobby picture from here. So it kind of works out. Oh, JoJo's not coloring anything right now, but she just got the 120 brush chip Ohuhus. So you're swatching those. Oh, very nice. Angie, how are you? I have been thinking about you so much lately. I was rearranging my coloring books and the dog's book that you sent me, I pulled it out. And I was looking through it and I was actually talking to Frank about you and I told him that you sent me the book. And I was looking to see if there were any dachshunds in it and I don't think there are. Can you believe that? But besides that, thank you for the book. I love it. And I always have the little note in there that you sent it to me. So I think of you often. Oh, there's not a Fantastic Beasts book? Oh, yeah, I don't know. I'm behind on all that kind of stuff. I stopped reading after Harry Potter, so I'm lost. I'm like a Harry Potter OG, and that's just kind of as far as it goes. And honestly, I love the books. I read all the books, and I've seen all the movies, but I'm not like a hardcore Harry Potter fan. I like it. I enjoy it, and I just don't, like, watch them all the time. If we catch them, I'll, like, you know, we'll watch them, but I'm not like, oh my god, I need to have this. So, I don't remember, like, all their names, that kind of stuff. I know, but hey, why did I join a Harry Potter color along? I'm not, like, a hardcore fan, but hey, I did. So, here we are. So, I'm gonna assume that this is Hedwig. Because it's really cute and it like looks like Harry and yeah, but it's even the first page is super cute in this. Oh, thanks, Pamela. Hi, Patches and Pages. I was going to say something and it totally went out of my mind. So anyway, I'm going to start the flip through of this so that way you can see what it looks like. It's a very interesting book. It's got a lot of like holiday and Christmas things in here, but I think it's really cute. Especially, it was $6 on Amazon. That's where I found it. All you have to do is look up Harry Potter Chibi and you'll find them. They're all over the place. And I just like the cover of this one. So I don't know what's in the other ones, but I think the cover of this is super cute. And I'll show you the ISBN number just in case you decide you want to order it. Here it is. So there you go. It's possible. It's possible. I don't know. Hey, Lucy. Good to see you. Thanks for stopping in. Hey, Allie. Thanks for hanging out with us. Yeah, it is pretty cute, right? So this one really confuses me. Is this Santa Claus with like an Easter egg? I'm not sure what the heck is going on here. I would say it's Hagrid, but I don't know. I really can't tell. So you guys that are hardcore Harry Potter fans, you tell me. But I don't know. Either way, it's cute and I like it. So, but the reason I said is that Santa Claus is because there's this picture, and this is definitely Santa Claus, and definitely celebrating Christmas. So, this is cute. I guess this is Harry and the Weasley twins, right? And that's Hermione. I don't know if that's Ron, and I don't know who this is. But, yeah. You think it's Hagrid with a dragon egg? Because I think my son is coming by with his iPad. Nobody wants to listen to the shows that he watches, so. Oh, I guess it could be. I guess it could be a phoenix egg, my love. I don't know. But it's a cute book. It's just kind of really caricature-ish. But then there are ones that are like this that are a little bit less caricature-ish and more like just people. So, I don't know. But this is obviously a Halloween one. So I guess this is a, like, through the seasons kind of thing. I don't know, but it's cute. Hey, Joy, how you doing? I could totally see this page just all glittery. Couldn't you? Like, you could just really do this one for Halloween. It's got, like, I don't know if it's hot chocolate or the pumpkin juice stuff that they drink or whatever, but it could be whatever you want in the cup, but it's got, like, whipped cream or whatever. I think it could be a really cute, glittery Halloween page. At least that's how I would do it if it was me coloring it. I really like this one. Obviously, this is Ron, so then this would be Harry. He doesn't have his mark, but that's okay. And she's sitting there reading a book by the fire, and they're playing a game. So I love this one. I think it's so adorable. Now, this one I definitely think is Hagrid, because that looks more like Hagrid than the other one. You see, like, Hagrid, I don't know, it just looks more like him than the Santa Claus one. But I don't know. So, it's obviously different artists. Or, I don't know where this came from or whatever, but it's on Amazon, so, you know, it's whatever it is. Now, what were their names? The Dursleys? Was that who these people were? His, like, first family that adopted him or his cousins or whatever? I don't remember. Here's another cute one. Couldn't you see this tablecloth being like a dark purple? Like, if you're good enough to go in with like watercolors using your Neo 2s on this and like mixing the colors up and making that like a really, like a purple, like a light, not light purple, but a purple and a dark blue and mixing it up and then putting little like Posca in there for stars and stuff, I think that would be really cute. And then of course, we gotta have some glitter, so. Yeah, I'm glad they kept her big hair, too. That's part of Hermione, right? Like, she has to have the big hair. So, I'm not sure. What is this girl's name? Luna? Is that Luna? What's her name? Luna Lovegood? I don't remember. God, it's been so long since I watched Harry Potter or read the books. I'm trying to get Emilio into it, but it's really kind of you know, he's kind of young for it. He's only 5, so we haven't even put the movies on. I'm afraid after the first movie he might get scared, so I'm kind of holding off on it a little bit, and he definitely doesn't have the attention span to sit there and listen to me read the book, so that it's going to be a little bit of time. So obviously this one is Dumbledore. I'm going to like just zoom it a little tiny bit closer. It's Dumbledore and the Phoenix, I guess, right? And he's knitting. And I like his book is levitating, so that's very helpful. That would be really helpful if we had those kinds of powers when we're doing our crafts, right? I think that's really cute. Oh, you did, Angie, you read the first book to your son when he was 6? Emilio won't be 6 until January, and we just make it through, like, the board books before he gets bored with it. He does read, like, you know those step-up reader books? He doesn't mind those ones with the, like, really big words. He'll sit and he'll like it. But he's, like, when we watch things on the iPad together, he's very much, hey, let's watch this. And I get into his stupid shows, and I'm like, don't turn it off. I want to see what happens. But he just wants to go here, there, and everywhere. So I don't think he's just ready for that yet. But we did have a Back to the Future marathon last weekend, and he was really enjoying it, actually, even though it has nothing to do with the books. But he did like those movies. He was sitting down. He was very interested in the DeLorean. So he's getting more and more able to sit for a longer period of time. We watched Sonic. He liked that. He fell asleep through it at the end of it, so he missed the end of it. But he watched Onward with us, with the what are those guys, those little trolls or whatever they are, the Disney movie. So he watched that. And what was the other one that we watched? We bought another movie that he wanted to watch, and I can't. Oh, the Scooby-Doo movie. And he sat through the whole thing of that, and he really liked it. So we're getting there a little at a time. He's got ants in his pants, so it's hard to get him to concentrate. But one of his favorite movies is Jaws, believe it or not. We took him to the beach to see Jaws last year when they, you know, when we could still do things outside of the house. And they had a showing of Jaws at the beach, and he loved it. He sat in my lap the whole time, and he thought it was, the greatest thing. And, like, every week that whole summer, he was like, oh, can we watch that shark movie again? So you never know what the kids are going to like. Hey, Glitterature. Hey, Sydney. Nope, you're not late. We're just doing a flip through. Never too late to come in and hang out with us, so thanks for joining us. Yeah, he still has ants in his pants at 21. Angie, I hear you. Oh, I don't know, honestly, if that's Cho or Ginny Patches. Where did it go? I'm going to go with Ginny, just because that's who, well, you know, spoiler alert. I think it's Ginny. Let's just say that. But if you like Cho better and you bought this book, you can make it Cho. So that's what I would say. Yes, he did like the Rocky Horror Picture Show. You're right, my love. He did like that one. Hi, Rain Chains. Oh, Sci-Fi has on all the Harry Potter movies. That's so good to know, Glitterature. This is a Harry Potter chibi coloring book. That's just what it's called, the Harry Potter chibi coloring book. I got it from Amazon. So if you just search Harry Potter chibi, you can find it easily. Now, I'm guessing this is Nearly Headless Nick, right? That was his name? I don't know how I remember some of them, and others I can't. I don't remember at all. So I look at this one, I instantly think Harry's going to pick his nose. But that's just me. I love all the owls looking in the window in this one. Do you see those guys? That's so cute. So here's one, very appropriate for the time. I totally think I just want to do this whole, like, all the words in glitter, like glitter gel pen. I think that would be really nice. Or maybe even go over them with stickles. I don't know, but I think it's really nice, and I would probably, like, cut that out and put that on my wall. I think it's a good thing to always keep in your mind. Oh, This is a limited edition and it's sold out. I just got it like 2 days ago. How's that possible, Charlotte? Wow. If there's any other chibi books in there, I'm sure they're the same. It's really the luck of the draw on these, but they're so cheap that really, you can't really go wrong. This is a really cute one with Hagrid. And I guess that is his little, I don't remember, dragon egg or whatever.
Yeah.
Yes, you did call it. Here's another one with all the little different things. 9 3/4, and is that Luna's glasses, and the snitch, and the sorting hat. I don't remember what that is, but there's Harry's glasses. So yeah, they're really cute. It's got a good representation of the movies, I think. And it's kind of cute for kids. And what book would be complete without our friend here, Mr. Snape? Can't have a book without him. And then Hermione with her cat. I can't remember his name. Anybody remember his name? He has a weird name. Nope. Can't remember it at all. I love cutie books too, Elizabeth. And here's what we're going to work on today. So this is a Christmas Dobby picture. This is the last page in the book. So that's it. It just has like a plain page at the end. So I had started it earlier. And Crookshanks. That's it, Elizabeth. Thank you. I knew that that cat had a weird name. So I don't know if this is Crookshanks here. I'm guessing it is, and that's Hedwig, and obviously we have Dobby here in his little socks. So, I started coloring this with Luminance pencils. So I brought up my Luminance and I brought up my Holbein. So I figured I'm just going to try to work with them. Usually on streams, I just use my, Prismacolors. So tonight I thought I'd switch it up a little bit. We're not here to really watch me color. We're just here to gossip and gab and see what's going on. So, I'm not going to continue on too much with the chair, because I really want to color Dobby. So I'll do a little bit of the chair and then we'll go on and we'll color Dobby and see what we can do with him. So tell me, what you guys have been up to and what your plans are for the weekend. How are things evolving in your neck of the woods at this time? Are you able to go out? Are things opening up? Things are starting to open up here on Long Island. A few stores open. Restaurants are allowed to have outdoor seating now, so that's kind of nice. And people are starting to get out and about. So, yes, I know. I know how tall you are, my dear.
Thank you.
We're still kind of playing it safe. We're staying in the house. Not completely all the time, but we are staying in a lot of the time and just trying to still keep our distance and be safe. I don't know. I just feel like people are rushing to get stuff open and I'm kind of afraid. I just want to see what's going to happen. And since we don't really have anything that we need to do or anywhere that we need to go to. The most things that I miss are going on our like little road trips. And I kind of miss going to Barnes & Noble and just browsing around, getting a coffee and that kind of stuff. I do miss that, but can I live without it for now? Yeah. Anyway, Barnes & Nobles have all opened up here where you can go shopping indoors, but it's like a limited amount of people in the store. You gotta wear a mask in the store, and I'm just really not all that thrilled about, bringing Emilio into stores right now. You know, so much talk has stopped, and we don't know what's happening with the kids that were having that illness and stuff, and I don't know. It just kind of scares me still. So we're just keeping our distance and we're going to the beach and, you know, obviously at the beach, you're not really near anybody unless you go with someone. So it's kind of safe there and just doing our thing. I'm actually on leave from work for right now. So I have the next less than 30 days off, but I have the next 3 weeks off. So that's nice. I was off all of this past week. So that was super nice. And I'm just enjoying my time. Been working with Emilio and doing schoolwork and playing and also getting some reading and coloring time in. So that's about it. Oh, you're moving. Wow. Well, good luck, Elizabeth. I'm sure it'll go well for you. Yeah, I'm hearing that, Angie. I'm hearing a lot of other places in the country have spiking cases going on, so that scares me a little bit. Yeah, you too, Shayna. The numbers are going up there, right? Some people say it's because there's more testing going on, but I don't know. Honestly, don't know. I'm really... Yeah, I agree, Marilyn. And hi, Marilyn, by the way. We're staying home doing our walks and doing stuff like that, too. We don't bring Emilio in any stores and... Oh, are the cases going up, Robin, in Massachusetts? Yeah, you guys are kind of close to us, and I know that the governors were really working together on things, but I just haven't been watching the governor too much because I was watching him every day while this was all, like, going on and whatnot. And then as the numbers started to die down, I noticed a lot of his talks were getting very, like, political around here, and it was kind of like him talking about the same thing every day, and it was, like, less about COVID and more about, like, building jobs and making airports, and I was just like, I'm not here for this, you know, I really want to know about the COVID, and if that's not what we're going to talk about, I'm not going to watch it. So I kind of stopped watching him, and I haven't been watching the news too much, so... I'm not really fluent on what's going on in different states and stuff. I just know that New York is in, well, at least Long Island. Long Island, where I live, is in phase two. So we just hit phase two, I think, yesterday or something. And places are just starting to open up now. But just monitoring it. I'm really scared of a second wave, you know? Oh, Mona, you're in phase three upstate? Yeah. Oh, gosh. Yeah, there's just so much going on in the world right now, and, oh gosh, Angie, you have to work in the ER tomorrow. Well, we're thinking of you. We thank all of our frontline workers, everybody who's been in the trenches for sure since the beginning of this until, you know, we find a cure, but we thank you for that. Yeah, that's the kind of way that we feel too, Sheriff. Don't have to go out, we don't. I agree, Christy. Hospital spikes are a concern. And, you know, my worry about it is that everybody kind of around here, I notice, is acting like, well, you know, it's over now. But it's not over. You know, just because things are starting to open up, it's not over. And once you let people out and start doing things again, how do you rein them back in if this becomes a problem again? That's what I worry about. So, I don't know. Maybe I worry for nothing, but... I'm not really worried about me. I'm just more worried about my Emilio. His summer camp got canceled, even though they said they were going to reopen the camps. His director decided that she wasn't going to do it. She didn't want to take the kids' lives into her hands and say, you know, I can't guarantee anything. So I'm very happy about that. Yeah, I wouldn't either, Mona. I would not chance it. I have four autoimmune diseases, so am I on that high, what do they call it? Like the, you know, the level of people that shouldn't go out? Yeah, I'm on that level too, but I really don't worry about myself. I'm a mama bear, and I worry about my boy, so, you know, and I also worry about my mom. So we've really been distancing from her too. We saw my mom for her birthday, but that's really it. And she feels the same way, that, you know, it's not worth taking the chance. Once they have a cure or an idea of a good way to treat this or whatever, then I think it'll be a little bit better. I agree, Angie. I've known a few people now that have passed away from this, even though, you know, there's all the conspiracy people that nobody's died from this or whatever, but I don't believe in any of that, so we're not going to go down that road. But I know a few people that have passed away from it, and I personally know someone who had it very bad and was on a ventilator for weeks, and he was a very young man, 34 years old, and he almost didn't make it. So I don't know why people don't take it seriously. It's so serious, you know, but hey, you can only take care of yourself and take care of what you believe and what you think. You can't change other people's minds. So
So I think if social media teaches anything, it's that. You can't change other people's minds. People have their minds made up and are going to do what they're going to do. So you just have to take care of your own, in other words.
But it's nice that we have this, and it's nice that during these times, especially, you have people that you can connect with and hang out with online, and at least you have someone that you can talk to. I mean, years ago, gosh, like back when 9/11 happened, right? We didn't have any of this kind of communication or online stuff or whatever. So you think back to just 2001, if something like this happened, people would have really been stranded during that time. Oh my gosh, really, Patches? That's crazy. Yeah, it's true, Marilyn. I agree. I know people need to make money too. That's, you know, that's the rub of it. People are having a hard time with that too, you know, with being out of work and small businesses closing. And you know, there's the other side of it too, where some businesses are not going to be able to reopen because of what's happened. So it's hard for everyone all around. That's why I said you really can't change people's minds. All you can basically do is just take care of your own family and what you think is best, and you know, do the best that you can. So that's what we're doing. But I'll tell you, when this all started and we all got locked down, I was so not sad about all the stuff that I had in the house. I was like, well, I'm totally prepared. I am prepared for the apocalypse. We are here. And I have a million coloring books and coloring things and books to read, so it's all good. I was totally okay with it. Did I order? Do I still have packages coming every day? Yes. I know I'm not alone in that. I know y'all are ordering for the most part. But yes, I noticed that on social media, it's become a thing. People are definitely quarantine ordering, so there's that. Amazon's become like my best friend. I don't even go out food shopping anymore. I actually have everything delivered because why not? Hey, Emily. Emily! Oh, it's Emily Illustrator. She's another person that's going to be streaming this weekend. So make sure to check out the schedule. If you haven't seen the schedule of who's going to be streaming and when, check it out from Coloring with Vicky. She's actually our wonderful organizer, and she has organized this whole thing. So Vicky, thank you so much for that. And everyone go see, I believe, Emily, you're streaming tomorrow, right? Let everyone know when you're streaming so that they can join. Angie can't stop shopping. I know, I feel the same way. I can't either. Robin says, Jen, I'm homebound, so it didn't faze me one bit. Hubby and daughters are still working, so we're hanging in there. Well, I'm glad that you're safe, and we all definitely keep your family in our thoughts and prayers, because everybody that is essential and has to go out there, you know, it's really important, and we're really thankful for everybody that goes out there and does it. Oh, I'm glad to stream, glad to hang out with you guys. Okay, everybody, Emily will be on in an hour and a half, so as soon as I'm done, she'll be on. So everyone, go over to Emily Illustrator, I can't speak, Emily Illustrator, and subscribe. She's going to be on tomorrow too. She's a fantastic colorist, so you definitely want to go over and check her out. I know she'll be coloring something fabulous. So Emily, thanks so much for joining in. I'm actually going to have some time this weekend, so I think as long as the boy leaves me alone, he really likes me to play with him now. That's why you guys don't see many videos from me, because I don't get much time where he leaves me alone like he used to. You know, you guys remember my OG subscribers. You know, I always used to get time where he would just be doing his own damn thing, and he'd be like, get away from me, you're annoying me. No, he wouldn't say that, but he would just do his own thing. Now he constantly wants to be like up in my business, and I'm not even kidding when I say this, but when I go to the bathroom, it's so bad that he sits outside the door and plays with his toys, and the dog sticks her nose under the door and keeps sniffing until I come out. So it's so much fun. So yeah, streaming and coloring is, I mean, not coloring, well, kind of coloring, but
streaming and making videos is such a hard thing for me now. I haven't been feeling so hot this week. I've not been getting a lot of sleep. This past week I've been up a lot. I'm just gonna turn the book a little bit. So, I haven't felt so hot this week and just not really video appropriate, if that makes sense. I haven't felt like I would be making a good video. I'm stumbling over my words a little bit just because I'm not getting the proper amount of rest. So I figured next week I'll probably be feeling better. It usually passes. And then I have a few videos I want to make for you guys. I have some new coloring books that I want to show you. And I have a haul of new things and some things that the artist sent me. So I have some definite things to show you. And I have the time. I have to get time away from my 5-year-old and my 1-year-old pup. Because... yeah, we don't even go to the bathroom without them now. Oh, and also, I have to say, have you guys ever seen me without nails? I don't think you've ever seen me make a video without nails. This is the first time ever. So I've been doing my own nails. For the time being, I've decided not to put my acrylics back on. I know what is happening, but I've really liked seeing how not doing them has saved me money. I've invested in some nail polish, and since my last stream, that was the night that I took them off. Right after the stream was over, we watched the most recent Star Wars movie, and I took them off that night. And I haven't had anything done since then. I've just been doing them myself, and I've been enjoying it. So, oh, thank you, Charlotte. They're okay. They're not what I'm used to. I miss my acrylics, but I don't think I'm going to do them anymore, at least not now, for the foreseeable future. Oh my gosh, Emily did a Gryffindor manicure. I will so be at your stream, Emily. I need to see the Gryffindor manicure. That sounds fantastic. I'm so excited to see that. I do not have that kind of talent, but I'm so excited to see that. Thank you for telling me. I know, right? What weapons am I going to be? I used to get the weirdest comments from people with when I had my nails on, especially when I used to get them done wider. Gosh, they used to say, like, they really like my videos, but my nails freaked them out, so they couldn't watch. That was, like, the most hated thing that I got on my comments all the time was my nails, and it didn't bother me one bit. Like, I loved my nails, so whatever anyone thought about them, whatever. But nail salons and all that are not open here still. And I think they're coming into phase 4. And honestly, I'm not all about running into a place to get my nails done at this point. Like, and being all up in there with my mask on the whole time. It just doesn't seem like a relaxing, like, experience. So, I'm not gonna be doing it right now. Can I say I will never do it? No. But most likely, it's not going to be any time in the near future. My mom and I were talking about it, and we both kind of feel the same way. Like, it just doesn't seem like the thing that we want to do right now. So for now, I'm just going to leave them off. But I love this company. I don't know how well you can actually see. What am I doing here? Okay, here we go. This nail polish is from, it's called Live Love Polish. I don't know if you can really see. Let me bring the light over. But this is the most glittery polish I've ever had in my life. And you know what? I'm not in the sun. And I don't, like, just now I had the direct light on them. But just normally, they look this glittery. And you know how sometimes they don't? Like, they look like real crap in the house. But when you go outside, they look amazing when you have some sort of glitter polish. These always look like it. So I ordered a few polishes from them, and I love them. I think their company is located in Jersey. And I found them on Instagram. I kind of wanted to just shop off of some companies that are just not mainstream. Another awesome company I found for nail polish is called Cirq Colors. C-I-R-Q-E or U-E? I don't remember. I think it's U-E. They're a Brooklyn-based company. They're a vegan nail polish. They have this black nail polish called Memento Mori. I am not kidding you. It is one coat, and it's totally opaque black. I've never seen another one like that. So What can I say? I love it, and I wear it all the time. When I don't have, like, a glitter on, I just have, like, plain black on, and I love this Momentum Ore. It's really, really nice. Oh, thank you, guys. They're okay. They, you know, they'll do, so I'm happy with them. Color Street. So, a lot of people have been talking to me about Color Street, and I have a cousin who has just sent me, like, 2 nail strips to try. She just started a business. So I'm gonna try them and see how it goes. Typically, I paint my nails, like, every 2 days, because once they start chipping, I can't stand it anymore, and then they gotta go. But I really don't mind doing it, because it's nice and relaxing. So, we'll see. I'll try these strip things and see how long they last and if I like them. I tend to get bored with nail polish too, so that's why the changing it every 2 to 3 days doesn't bother me, but we'll see. They look nice, and I know a lot of people are doing them right now, so I'll see how it goes, and if I like it, maybe I'll switch over to that. Although, they do seem like a little expensive, but I guess if you're not changing them as often, like I think they're supposed to last 7 to 10 days, it's probably not that expensive, so we'll see. A friend that I have, it's actually Emilio's old teacher, she's hooked up with Color Street through a animal rescue. So if you purchase through her, the animal rescue gets money. So I would probably do that if I decide to go there. I know, I don't like wearing the mask either. I'll tell you, the first time I wore a mask, I had to go into Walgreens when they first, like, you didn't have to have it, but it was, like, strongly recommended. And I literally thought I was gonna faint. I was like, oh my god, I'm hyperventilating. I hate this. I don't like this at all, but I got used to it. And actually, I mean, this is not gonna be a surprise at all when I say this, but I have a glittery mask coming. It's actually been shipped out to me already, so I'm waiting for it to come. It's a black mask with black Swarovski crystals on it, because I figured if I have to wear one, it's gotta be me, right? So yes, I ordered it. It was only like $25. It's from this company called Blinged Up. So I know, I'll post a picture of it on my Instagram when I actually get it. But I've been waiting forever for it, and I'm so excited to get it. I also ordered some Disney masks for myself and my mom and Emilio so that he has like 4 masks to wear. Because, I mean, they're saying kids might have to wear them in school. So, I don't know. We'll see. But, and then I ordered Frank, he found some Islander ones that he liked, so I got some for him too. So we all are covered. Oh, you didn't like the strips, Mona? You know what I use over the top? Sesh Vite, only because it goes really fast. So it just dries like almost instantly. So it's probably not the worst, but because it dries so fast, I know that's why it probably chips faster, but with Emilio and the dog, I need to have something fast, so I just use that. Oh, Christy wants to know if it's difficult to remove this polish. Yeah, I hear you. I hate that too, and I used to have to file off the glitter from some of the polishes, but these, it comes off so easily. I use the pure acetone to get my nail polish off, but you can use regular nail polish remover and it takes it right off. It does not... The glitter is not chunky, so like it's a very smooth feel with this Live Love polish. It doesn't feel like that weird chunkiness that you get with some of those nail polishes that have a lot of glitter. So yeah, you won't experience that with this. So I really like them. This is like definitely my favorite company of all the polishes. And then there's that Cirque nail polish that I really like as well. And you actually can get the Cirque nail polish on Amazon. I think you do have to pay shipping, but I know, right? I knew you wouldn't be surprised, Mona, about my mask. Angie, are you getting those marks on your face from your mask for having to wear it for so long? We have a friend who's a nurse, and he said that he gets it too. I have some of the I Love Nail Polish too, Emily, and I do like that one, but this one's even better. Oh, you miss taking your granddaughter to get her nails done, Pamela? I know. You can do them for her, though, but I don't know if you're seeing her or not. But my mom, actually, her birthday was the beginning of the month, so she came over, and I did her nails for her because she had gels on, and she didn't have any acrylics on, but she had the gels on, and she finally, all the gels finally came off. So I did her nails. I like cleaned up her cuticles for her, and I painted them. We did it like a socially distant type of thing. Like, she sat away from me and just reached over so I could do her nails, but it just made her feel good. And it was for her birthday, and Emilio baked her a coconut cake. He's a very good little baker. And then we got her some gifts and we made dinner for her, so it was nice. My mom's really, like, you know, she's really separated. My brother has been in Florida, and he just came back, and she's not really been seeing anyone. So I know that we brought, like, probably shouldn't have had her over, but it was her birthday, and it had been like 3 months since we saw her, and she misses Emilio so much. I mean, she used to watch him. She went from watching him every day to only 2 days a week, and then not at all with all of this going on. So she was lonely, and I really wanted to see her. So I'm gonna try to have her over for like a movie day, one of the days while I'm off. I think that'll be fun. And you know, we just try to keep separate from each other and keep washing our hands and doing the best that we can, but we can't never see each other, you know? So that's what we've been doing. So I saw the question go by before, but I didn't ask it, and I want to know now. So what house do you all guys belong in for Harry Potter? Are you, I know I'm Hufflepuff. Frank is a Gryffindor, I believe. He's in Harry's house, but I'm a Hufflepuff. And Emilio is a Slytherin, which absolutely fits him perfectly. So when we took the test with him and he came out as Slytherin, Frank and I looked at each other like, yeah, we do that one. So what are you guys in? Tell me. Ravenclaw. Elizabeth's a Ravenclaw. Shayna is a Hufflepuff. Glitterature's a Ravenclaw. Oh, that's cute, Veronica. You guys visit over the fence. Well, that's nice. At least you guys get to see each other kind of often, and you can talk whenever you want. You could have coffee over the fence if you want. So that's nice. Crater Stage? Is that right? It's a Ravenclaw. Charlotte's a Hufflepuff. Liz is a Ravenclaw. Wow, we have a lot of Ravenclaws here this evening. I don't think I've seen any Gryffindors come by. And I haven't seen any Slytherins, so, except for Emilio, but he's not in the chat. Also, guys, if you're chatting and you're in the box and it says up at the top chat, please change it to live chat, because if it's not on live chat, you won't see everyone's responses. Mona, we're twins, right? For life. Mona and I are such twins. She's also a Hufflepuff. I knew it. There's never any doubt. We are in it for life, girl. We are in it for life together. All right, I'm going to stop coloring this chair because I'm going to be here for a lifetime, especially because this is like, this is Amazon paper, right? So it's going to take a while to color. It's going to take layers, and it's going to take a while. So I actually want to get started on Dobby, and I want to use the Holbeins on him to see how they work on this paper, because I may have done it in the past, but I don't remember what it was. I haven't really colored on Amazon paper with just pencils in quite some time. So these are the luminance, so that way you can see. I mean, obviously it's going to take a lot of layers, but yeah, so there's that. So let's pick out some colors for Dobby now. He's kind of like a peachish, it's so hard to say that. He's like a peachy color, but also he's got like brown and stuff on him. So I'm going to go ahead and just put the peachy type color on him to start, and I'll pick up these colors and we'll see how far it goes. Usually only stream till like an hour to an hour and a half, but tonight I'm going till 9. And then for those of you guys that are just coming in or haven't seen, Emily Illustrator will be on right after me. She's also streaming tomorrow. She's got a Gryffindor nail polish for tonight's stream, probably for tomorrow too. So you definitely want to go over and check her out. So I'm going to go ahead and just sharpen these and keep reading what houses you guys are in. So Charlotte's a Hufflepuff, and Liz is a Ravenclaw. Zeely's a Gryffindor. Yay, we have a Gryffindor. So, how many of you guys are like diehard Harry Potter fans? Do you watch it all the time? Do you reread the books? I've never reread the books. I'm not a rereader, to be honest with you. I always feel like I just don't have enough time to do everything that I want to do. Like, literally last night I was up till 3:30 in the morning coloring a color by number Mickey Mouse picture because I did it with pencils. I usually do them with markers, and I wanted to see how it was with the pencils, and even though it took twice as long, I really liked the way it worked. So, if you go to my Instagram, I actually posted the picture. I don't have the book up here, but I bought a whole bunch of, like, those... I was going to zoom in a little bit. I bought a whole bunch of those really nice Disney coloring books. So I was working on that, and I just had so much fun doing it. And I was rocking out to the Red Hot Chili Peppers all by myself because the family was all sleeping. But I've had trouble sleeping, so... Yeah, I know. It is hard. I used to, you know... Let me see, a few weeks ago, and it always happens around my period, not to be like TMI and all this kind of thing, but for a person like me that has 4 autoimmune diseases, but mostly the ones that bother me the most, well, no, I'd say there's 3 that bother me the most. The chronic fatigue, which I've just learned to live with because, to be honest, I've had it since I'm 18. The fibro is painful, and I also have psoriatic arthritis. So, like, when you see all this stuff on my hand, you see how my hand... The skin is different right here than the rest of it. I don't know how much you can see it because I'm really zoomed in, but I have psoriatic arthritis and my fingers, these 3 fingers are really swollen, if you can see by the knuckles. So I have them in those 3 fingers. And if you look at the rest of my fingers, they're not swollen like that in the knuckles. But because of that, it bothers me. Like, those are the things that bother me the most. So, like Marilyn said, like, she could sleep 15 hours. It was a few weeks ago, I slept for 15 hours. I literally would get up for a few minutes, go to the bathroom, and think, oh, I'm gonna hang out here, and then crash out. And I just kept sleeping and sleeping and sleeping, and I just couldn't fight it. There was just no way to fight it. My body literally just shut itself down. It was like, girl, that's it, you're done. And that's what happens. I mean, I don't know if anyone else that has, like, health issues experiences that sort of thing, but for me, yeah, it was... It happens, like, probably once a month where I just cannot stop sleeping. And with everything going on in the world, there's so much going on, and it's so worrisome in so many different ways that I just haven't been getting sleep. And I almost feel like I'm staying up trying to make sure that nothing happens while the family is asleep. I don't know if that is stupid, but... That's kind of how I feel. Don't worry, Mona 1 and Mona 2. You both can go. Robin's here. She's good for everything. Oh, Shayna, you like to reread the books? Yeah, I know. And the books are so huge. So that's what the problem with that is. And Lucy says she has fibro and... have been diagnosed with arthritis in your spine. Yep, that, I hear you, Lucy. I have, well, I told you, fibro, I have chronic fatigue, and I have psoriatic arthritis, and I have Sjogren's syndrome. So, I just have, you know, like, everything. I don't have everything, but I have a lot that sucks. Let's put it like that. And, yeah, with everything going on, like, I would like to sleep, but my mind just won't stop going, and... I feel like I'm just up all the time, and then I'm, like, so tired during the day. You've never seen a Harry Potter movie or read the books, Pamela? Any reason why, or are you just not, like, not interested, or just never picked it up, and maybe you'd be interested someday, or what do you think about that? You slept for 17 hours, Robin? Yeah, I hear you. I definitely have those days, too. Oh, we're so glad to have you, too, Sydney. Yeah, Angie. Angie, do you think that the sleeping issues are from your shifts, or do you think it's just for health issues and something like that? Okay, so Elizabeth says she has dystonomia. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, but let's see. She says, my body doesn't know how to control automatic things. My heart races at 170. Whoa, in my sleep, so my body doesn't rest. Yeah. Yeah, I don't think I have that, but I do experience the heart racing when I lay down myself. And I always think to myself, oh God, what's happening now? Because I always think the other shoe's going to drop. And like, it's like not possible that a person has this much crap wrong with them. But yeah, so I definitely know about that. And Pickle says she has days like that, that she could sleep all day long too. Yeah, it does just hit you out of nowhere. And like, you can't tell it, no, I'm not going to do that. It's just like not having it on those days. It's funny how that happens. It just, all of a sudden, your body all of a sudden just takes control of you. Like, you are no longer in control. Lucy says, I think I could deal with it all if I could get rid of the tiredness. Yeah. Oh, tell me about it, Angie. Tell me about it. I feel you so hard on that one, worrying about everything. And I really am like trying not to, but how do you not to with this world and the illnesses? And oh gosh, like, I'm so worried Emilio is going to be going to kindergarten this year, and they don't even know what that's going to look like yet. Is it going to be virtual? Is he actually going to go to school? And I'm so worried about it. And I would just love to be like, you know what, I'm just going to homeschool him. But I know that that's not fair to him. So that's the only reason I haven't pulled that trigger, but I'm just, oh gosh, with everything going on and this COVID and the kids with the, whatever it is that they're getting from the COVID, it just worries the hell out of me. And truthfully, if this is going to kick up again, I just wish it would kick up again before the kids go to school so that I could just have him home with me and they can figure out a new way to do things until they have some sort of cure or treatment or whatever, because it's just something that's on my mind every single day. Oh, Pamela says she's just not into him. Fantasy movies or books are not my thing. You love reading memoirs. What's your favorite memoir, Pamela? I like memoirs too. I think the most recent one I read was Jessica Simpson. I read that when Emilio was in the hospital. I think that's probably the last nonfiction one that I read, but I could be wrong about that. Oh, okay, Elizabeth. Okay. Oh, gosh, Robin, you have congestive heart failure. That is so scary. I'm so sorry to hear that. Well, do you find, Robin, that your reading helps you to get your focus away from your health issues? I know it does for me sometimes when I can focus on it. Other times I'm just like, I can't even think about it. Miranda likes to reread. What's your favorite book to reread, Miranda? Liz says, I had a panic attack 2 years ago. Thought I was having a heart attack. Then 3 days later, got the shingles. Oh, man. The shingles suck. I had the shingles twice in the past 2 years. Those things stink. I got them from getting sick from some illness. I got some kind of weird-ass virus in Disney World in 2018 on our last trip. And I felt crappy that whole trip. And there were so many times where I, like, just couldn't even do anything. And I would go up to the room and rest. And Frank would take Emilio and, like, take him out to go do something. And I was like, damn, I'm ruining this whole trip. But I feel so horrible. I'm like, I really don't know what to do about it. And then the last day there, I had pain in my shoulder and my chest. And I thought for sure, I'm like, this is it. I'm having a heart attack. I'm not going to make it home. Well, nope, I had the shingles. No, I know, Angie. I know. It'll be for the rest of my life. My mom tells me the same thing. Marilyn, you only ever sleep 6.5 hours? Is it because you have to keep tossing and turning because of the pain? I mean, I definitely experience that too with the fibro, with the tossing and the turning. I just have to continue moving after a few hours. I get so stiff and in so much pain just from laying in the same spot. See, I am using Holbein's right now, but down here on the chair, I was using my Luminance pencils. Oh, okay, Pickle. Well, thanks so much for hanging out with us. You go get yourself some rest. 1 o'clock in the morning is kind of late, unless you're me and just stays up all night coloring and making till 3:30. I thank you so much for hanging out, and thanks for joining with us, and maybe I'll see you in another stream over the weekend. Yeah, reading, I found that too, Angie. I love to read, and I finally have been able to get back into it, but when, like, all this COVID all broke out, I could not concentrate on anything. Like, I was coloring up a storm because I could not focus on a book at all. Like, I couldn't even read one page. I would keep reading the same thing over and over again. My mind was just so alive with, like, what is going on, and how is this possible that this is all happening so fast, and all that kind of thing, so... I definitely hear you on that one. I've been able to calm myself, and I've been really enjoying some books lately. So, I've been doing both reading and coloring in the short spurts that I can get it, which is another reason that I stay up so late, is because once my family goes to sleep, that's like me time. So that's when I do my reading. That's when I do my coloring, whatever I decide for the night to do. So, yeah, that's another, like, poor reason to stay up so late and not get the amount of sleep that I need, but hey, I like it. I like being quiet. I like being alone. I'm an introvert in that way, that I really like my alone time to work on my crafts and my hobbies and things like that, so, yeah, that's just what I do. That's how I work it. You know what is another, like, really weird thing? I always notice that I color worse when I'm streaming than I do when I'm, like, sitting by myself and just coloring or you know, whatever, whenever I'm coloring. I guess it's because I'm so unfocused. Like, I'm here, I'm trying to color it, but I'm also trying to talk to you guys and look at the screen. So just don't think too much about my coloring here. It's not so great. I'll fix it up when I get done. Pamela says the last one she read is a Price of Cake by Cupcake Brown, or is it A Piece of Cake? Reading is your panacea, Robin. Well, that's nice. That's really nice, and I hope that it always is for you. Do you still color, Robin? Or do you do anything else now besides the reading, or you just do that? I haven't seen you, like, in one of Dee Dee's streams in a long time, but I still go to Dee Dee's streams, especially when she's coloring, but I don't typically chat anymore because my work has changed so much since I first started watching Dee Dee that I used to be able to have time to chat. You know, I would always be working while listening to her, but I just don't have the time to do it anymore, so I kind of just listen. A lot of times I'll just go back and watch her streams later on, but sometimes during the day I am there, I'm just not chatting, which could be the same thing for a lot of people. I don't know, but, I still like to go to her streams. I always feel like I always learn from her. Oh, I just hit my light. I have to scroll back up for a second. There was something there. Shara said, I have no sleep issues, but only sleep 5 to 6 hours, cannot take naps. Autoimmune prep since 11. Thankfully, don't bother sleep. Fibro makes me feel tired a lot, but still can't nap. Oh, I love naps. I'm so sorry you can't take naps. I love naps. Oh, you're doing cross stitching now, Angie? How do you like that? I've never done that, and now that my fingers are so bad, I wouldn't be able to do it anymore. It's hard to chat and color, Angie. You can see I'm not coloring that much. And it's not even coming out that good with what I am doing, but that's not the point. I'm not here to, like, you guys want to learn to color really well. You kind of want to watch, like, Sammy or Emily Illustrator. You would want to watch, who else is streaming? Passionista Colorista, Coloring with Vicky. They are the coloring queens. That you are going to learn something from. You're going to come to Jen from Reading with Pugs, and you're going to learn about probably, like, ghost things. You're going to learn about buying things and glitter and stuff like that. So you're not going to learn to color any kind of awesome picture from me, but that's not what we're here for. We're here for a fun time and to just, you know, talk. So it's all good. And I'm okay with that. Hi, Mona. You're back. Oh, you got some new stuff? Oh, do tell, Robin. What did you get? Oh, you're doing jigsaw puzzles. I like those. We've been doing those, too. We started doing some of those since, like, this whole thing happened. And they've been a lot of fun. I'm usually suck at them. I'm, like, really bad at them. But I've actually been improving, and I'm proud of myself. I've had fun doing them with Frank. Like, Emilio will start, but then he gets the ants in his pants, like I told you guys. And he's like, oh, I'm done with this. After he puts in, like, 8 pieces. And then he's gone. But so Frank and I finish them, and we enjoy it. It's fun. Oh, you're doing the cross-stitching too, Stacy? That's cool. Right, Patches? I always tell that to Emilio, too, when he tells me he hates to sleep. I'm like, not when, someday when you're an adult, you're going to love when somebody says to you, you want to take a nap. I remember those days pre-Emilio when I could just be like, oh, I'm going to take a nap. And off I would go and just take a nap anytime I want. So, yeah, kids don't get it. They don't know how good they have it. Could you imagine as an adult if somebody was just always like, hey, you feel like taking a nap? Why don't you go take a nap? I'd be like, see ya. Not even a second thought. Oh, Miranda's favorite is Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix to reread. That's cool. Yes, that's true, Pamela. Everyone does have their own style. That's true. Hello, Mona. You're also back. The two Monas are back. You put a do not disturb on the door. Oh. Veronica's starting to sew and is reading and coloring, too. Oh, you've made masks, Veronica? That's so awesome. I've noticed so many people doing that. That's really awesome. I don't have a sewing machine. And I don't really know how to sew. Like, I could sew a button back on, you know, if I had to and whatnot. But my strength in my hands is so bad that I just don't think I would be able to do it. Like, a lot of times, Frank just recently had to sew something back on. And he asked me, like, could I thread the needle? And I'm like, I can't do it. Because I feel like I'm touching it, but I'm not. So... Stacy does the no... count cross stitch. I don't know what that means, but it sounds good. I hope you have fun with it. Have I seen? No, I've been afraid to watch it, Angie. Is it good? I want to watch it, but I'm a little afraid. I have a lot of books now that I just got it's like a really huge thing that's out right now, obviously, with pandemic stuff in it. So I really want to read those, but I'm afraid I'm going to freak myself out. So I'm holding off a little bit on them, but I am watching a new docuseries on Netflix. It's, I don't know what it's called. So duh, but if you look up Lenox Hill Hospital on Netflix, you could find it. Lenox Hill Hospital is a medical facility here in New York. It's in New York City, and it's all about these different doctors in different departments and how things happen to them and how they have, like, different patients to treat and stuff like that, and I love it. I am a sucker for anything like that, so... my husband's going to take a nap, but okay. So, yeah, I think I'm on episode 8 and I only started it yesterday, but it's like really super good. Okay. I need to scroll up because Robin was telling me about all the goodies that she got. Okay. So she got the Arteza 120, the 36 skin tone, and the Cali Arts 180, 150 set of Prism colors, 84 Neo color twos, 120 Crayola, and a few books. Wow, that's pretty awesome. Wait, it continues. And she got the Jane Davenport skin tone palette. Fantastic, girl. I'm so glad you treated yourself because that sounds like so much fun. Oh, Shara, I'm so sorry you don't get as much pleasure from sleeping. People like me, I love to sleep. Oh my gosh, always have. Oh, Miranda's doing diamond painting. All right, I'm gonna have
have to check it out, Angie. I will definitely check it out now that you gave me the recommendation, because I trust you. So I will check it out. Hopefully I don't get scared. But yeah, I need to watch that. Hi, fairy girl. How you doing? This is called Harry Potter. You're probably not going to see it because I'm so zoomed in. This is the Harry Potter chibi coloring book. So if you go back and watch this later on, you'll see the flip through. I did a really long, annoying flip through of it, but you can definitely check it out and see the rest of the pages. But this is like just little, like a little Dobby coloring Christmas page. Of course it's a coloring page. You see, I told you my words. That's why I'm not putting up any videos, because I don't want to come out like a raving lunatic and people are gonna be like, what is she talking about? So I'm hoping next week my mind is a little bit more clear and I can start to talk like a normal person. But yeah, okay, so I'm gonna check out The Pandemic on Netflix. Anybody else watching anything good on Netflix right now that you want to recommend? The only thing I'm watching on Netflix, I watch the same things over and over again. I'm so boring, but I can't help it. I love them. So anyway, I'm watching that docuseries that just came out this past week on Lenox Hill Hospital. Very good. Definitely recommend that. Bye, Patches. Oh, Schitt's Creek is good too. I've heard about that. I'll have to check that out too. What was the other thing? Oh, so I always watch the same things on Netflix. I watch the Andy Kaufman thing with Jim Carrey, where it's, I think it's called Jim and Andy. I must have watched it like 60,000 times already, and I watch it all the time. So I watch that. And I watch almost all the seasons of Nurse Jackie in rotation. I do that a lot when I'm coloring, let me just say, because it's something that I know by heart, so I don't have to sit there and watch it. So I can actually picture it in my head because I've seen it so many times, and I don't need to see the action that's going on. I can just listen to it. So when there's nothing on like YouTube that I'm interested in, that's what I do. The other thing that I watch that I'm into at the moment, because I go through phases with these kinds of things, is, I don't know if you guys ever saw it, it was on in 2014, but I bought this series on Amazon, was Princesses Long Island. It was all about these Jewish girls that they featured for, it was only one season, but it was supposed to show you like a Jewish girl's life from Long Island. It really was a poor depiction of it, but it's so bad that it's good, and it's a guilty pleasure, and I watch it all the time. So that's what I have in the rotation right now. And then I will watch like some book videos on YouTube, and you know, if there's any good coloring things, like I have certain people that I have to watch all the time. Like Anne Hatfield, whenever she puts something up for coloring, I'm there, like that. KP Colors, Sammy, Dee Dee, you know, there's more that I'm not even mentioning that I can't think about at the moment. But yeah, there's always certain ones that I'm like jumping all over. Oh, hey, Jaya Scrappy, how you doing? Scrap Happy, I always say your name wrong. I apologize. You're watching The Great British Show. Okay, Dead to Me is good. Yeah, a lot of people like that one, Angie. You can't watch hospital-based shows. I know. I don't blame you on that one. You're a diehard 90 Day Fiancé fan, Pam. Yeah, I don't watch that. I can't bring myself to do it. You love Penny Dreadful? Oh, okay, Lucy. Well, thanks so much for coming and hanging out with us. It was so nice of you. Please get yourself some rest, and I really appreciate you stopping by. I don't even know what time it is. What the heck time is it? Anybody know? Oh, my God. What a disaster. Oh, it's 8:15. Okay. There we go. You too, Angie. Yeah, I love Anne. She's so cute. And you know, she's been putting up a lot of good hauls lately. So I love that. I am always up for a good haul, a good enable, you know, a good reason to get me something. Why not? Amazon and I are best friends, and I could always use another coloring book or nail polish. Although I did tell myself the other day, like, dude, seriously, cut down the coloring books. You have a billion. And for the most part, I do color in them all, but I have a few that I haven't colored anything in. And yeah, so I was like, no, I gotta weigh it in. There's someone's coming out that I want. Like, I just saw the other day Johanna Bassford's putting out a new coloring book, but it's kind of like a new but old one. It's a mini one of the Secret Garden, I think. So there's that one. I don't know if I'm gonna get that one. Oh, I love Zucchini Kitty too, Stacy. So many times I will put on her videos and I fall asleep. So her voice is just very soothing. So it's not that she's boring, but she just, her voice is very soothing. Let's see. Angie, I have coloring books in like almost every room now. Is I try to keep my favorite ones like close to me, and it's not, it's becoming like that's not gonna work anymore. So I'm gonna have to move them to different rooms in the house. But I'm trying to think who else. Oh, what's her name? Hannah Carlson has a new one coming out. I think it'll be August. So I'm waiting on that one. And then Alan Robert, he has a new horror coloring book coming out, I think, in September. And I think it's The Beauty of Horror 4, I want to say it is. So there's that one. What's her name? Maria Troll has a new one coming out. Luna, I think that one's coming out in August or September or something like that. I did hear that Clara Markova is having a new book coming out, but I don't know anything about it. So if anyone has any information, please share. But I don't know. And then Camila de Erico, who, you know, she's the one that does the mermaid. She came out with a mermaid one recently. I can't think of the name of it. But I love her books. And she has a new one coming out in September, too. So there's several new ones coming out, hardcovers. I need to make special room for my hardcover ones because I'm a lunatic like that. And yeah, so there's that. And there's so many cute freaking books out there, and there's so many things I want to color, but I also don't have the time that I used to. Like when I first started making videos, I don't have that time. So you know, I think to myself, you know, are they going to go to waste? Is it just one picture you want to color? I really have to, like, kind of weigh it out these days and say, is this something that I'm really going to do? So, you know, it's not a financial thing. It's just the room thing. You know, I don't have, if I had maybe my own, like, craft room or something, I could probably swing it. Pop Manga, thank you, Zelia. Yes, she has a new one coming out, and it looks super. I think it's called like Creepy Pop Manga or something from Camila de Erico. I know I'm all over the place, folks. This is just how I stream. But Camila de Erico has, I think it's called Cute and Creepy Pop Manga. It looks really cute, so go check it out. It's on Amazon for pre-order right now if you are interested. But, yeah, so if I had my own craft room, I could see myself like getting more books and having more organization. It would work for me because I don't have like an abundance of books like some people. I've seen like their videos and they have hundreds and hundreds. I have a lot of books, but I don't have hundreds and hundreds. My problem is I don't have a dedicated area for my craft stuff. So I have a dedicated area for my book stuff, but you know, even that is spilling over. So before Emilio was born, his room was my office. So, I could have, you know, definitely been able to spread everything out, but since I don't have that, I can't keep all my coloring stuff and my books together, and it just is, like, so much. I color on the couch. Where I am right now is in Frank's office. I mean, yes, we share it, but I don't even use it. Basically, he just uses it, so. That's right, JoJo's saying that Fabiana Attanasio has another mythographic book coming out too, called Paradise or Paradises or something like that. JS, I am using the Holbeins on this right now. And actually, I like the way they work better than the Luminance on this. They're soft. Obviously, the Holbeins are a really, really soft pencil. And I don't know if you can really tell,
But here, let me bring it in a little bit closer. So this is a good test. Not that my coloring is so freaking awesome or anything like that. But if you look at the Holbeins, like look at Dobby's face, there's hardly any white spots. Do you see that? But then look at the white spots from the Luminance because they're a harder pencil. So that's the difference in the pencils and the paper that you use. It really does make a difference. So I think the Holbeins just on their own are a much better pencil on this paper if you just wanted to, you know, do your layers and do your penciling and stuff like that. These seem to be much better than a harder pencil. So it would be like, you'd probably be better off using the Prismacolors than the Polychromos on this. But I don't know because honestly, it's been so long since I actually did like pencil tests on things. Typically on Amazon paper, I just go in with a marker base first. So, oh Mona, don't even get me started. I probably have like 1,000 digital books besides my other books. So yeah, I can't even be like, oh yeah, well I can do that. Nope. I have that too. And I just ordered a book from Amazon because I also like weigh the prices on things. Like I'll look to see how much a digital book is compared to the actual book. And if I'm going to get ripped off by buying the digital book, I'm like, no, I'm just not going to do that. Like if I could pay $1 more and have the actual book here, I can't see buying the digital book. You know, it doesn't seem like it's economically sane to do, so, or sound, that's probably the word I'm looking for, economically sound. It's probably not. So like the new James Patterson book just came out. Excuse me, I'm choking myself. I'm so excited about James Patterson. So the new James Patterson book just came out. I haven't read his books in like years. But I was just telling this story on Facebook the other day. My mom, when I was a little girl, used to take me every summer because I was the only kid in the house, so there was no one like to play with at home. It was just me and my mom during the day. And there were no kids on my block either. So there was really no one to play with unless my friends came over. And when we were little, it just wasn't a thing. Like you just weren't constantly hanging out with your friends. So, or at least where I came from. So my mom every summer would take me to the craft store. And she would let me pick out any craft that I wanted to do for that summer. And she would buy me like a crap ton of stuff. Anything that I wanted to do to keep me busy, she would be like fine with it. So she used to take me and I used to get whatever I wanted. And then my dad would do the same thing, but he would take me to the bookstore. And he would let me get whatever I wanted at the bookstore to keep me busy for the summer. And I realized the other day that I just love that tradition, that I've kept that going up until this is the first year of my whole life that I can remember not doing that. So I would take Emilio to the craft store and let him pick out things. He's not old enough to have something to, you know, keep him busy for the entire summer, but I would take him and let him pick something out. And I also, I would always go and see if there was anything I was interested in, any painting, or if they had any coloring things I want. And if they weren't, then I would order myself something, you know, as part of my tradition. And then Frank would always take me to Barnes & Noble. Every spring, he would take me. So I didn't exactly do it in the summertime recently. We would do it in the spring. But he would take me and buy me a bag load of books. And that would be like my summer haul or whatever. And this is the first year we haven't been able to do it. And I always looked forward to getting the summer James Patterson book. And I realized I haven't done that in years. So I decided I'm going to read the new one that just came out, The Summer House. And I looked and Barnes & Noble wanted $28 for the hardcover to like go pick it up. And I was like, $28 seems like a lot. And then I went to Amazon and it was $16. And I was like, really? Like, I can't do that. That makes no sense. Like, I love you, Barnes & Noble, but yeah. So I just ordered it from Amazon and I wanted the hardcover so I could have like a little tiny haul for myself. I do get my book of the month still, so I have those. And so I'm reading the new James Patterson that came this week and I'm really enjoying it. It's been so long since I read one of his books. It's kind of like a throwback for me. So I'm enjoying that and doing that. So I got that and of course, I've been buying like a crap ton of coloring things since all the COVID and all that started too. So I really haven't like gone out and said, oh, I'm going to, you know, do that haul this year. But, you know, I'm still kind of doing it. I have used my Distress inks a little bit, Stacey, not a whole lot. I've been using them a little bit and they're fun. They just take some getting used to. And it's so funny that my coloring kind of dropped off a lot when I got them because of like just different things that changed at work. And my work suddenly picked up. So I didn't have as much like downtime as I was having like when all the COVID started. So I haven't really been using them too much. I've been using them for backgrounds and things like that. But I'm going to watch Zucchini Kitty, Karen, and watch her videos a little bit more of how she uses them on pictures. And I saw her use one actually in that Mermaids by Camila De Errico, the Pop Manga Mermaids one. And I really like how she did that one. And I would like to try to do the same thing, color that same picture. So... Yeah, my mom and dad, well, my mom is awesome. My dad was awesome, definitely, Savannah. It is a fun tradition, and I hope next year, you know, we can go back and do it. And I'm hoping to carry it on with Emilio. Obviously, he's a boy, so he's probably going to have different interests than myself. But he does like books, so I feel like I could definitely bring him to the bookstore and let him pick a few books in the summertime for him to read. He might not like crafts, and that's okay if he doesn't. What I will do instead is, if he doesn't like crafts, I'll take him and let him get a video game. He's really into his Mario Kart. He has a Nintendo Switch, and he's really been having so much fun playing with his dad. They play the Wii, like we have the old Wii, so they've been playing that, and they play the Switch together. So if it comes up to that when, you know, he gets older, then that's what we'll do. Oh, did you? I have those on my shelf, JS. I should read them. I just really felt like I wanted to buy the new one, and I'm enjoying it. It's pretty good. Just taking a drink, guys. Wow, you've read 60 of his books, Robin? I was into his women's murder series for a while, but then it kind of got, like, repetitive, and I was like, you know what? I think I'm done with this, and I just stopped reading it. But I like his standalone books a lot, and I like what Liz brought to my mind the other day, Hunting Jack the Ripper. Did anyone read that? It's, like, a young adult series that he has with another writer. That he works with, and it's so good. That is such a good series, and I loved Hunting Jack the Ripper. Such a good book. There is something on the tip of this pencil that's driving me nuts. Okay, got it. So, yeah. And then Ellen Hildebrand has her new book coming out just very soon. So I think it comes out next week. So I have that on pre-order because they didn't offer that through Book of the Month this month. But I did read the new Riley Sager. So if you guys are Riley Sager fans and you like his thrillers, his mysteries, this new one that he just came out with is so good because it's very ghostly. So if you like the paranormal, for some reason we always talk about ghosts on my channel, but if you like the paranormal thing, you're going to like this. It's a really good, creepy book, and you are just going to sit there and want to turn page after page in this book to find out what is happening to these people, and it's good. I have to say, I really, really enjoyed it. So, I have that one from Book of the Month, and I think that one comes out, like, June 28th or something. Oh, Veronica, I love my Parku markers. I'm still only using those. I haven't used any other markers besides those since I got them. And that says a lot because, like, with pencils, I'm always switching off. And I have a few sets of markers. I mean, companies have sent me markers. I've got Color It. I've got Arteza's. And I like them. But there's just something about those Parku markers that I just absolutely love. I don't know if it's the container. I don't know if it's the... I think, honestly, it's the color of the markers. They're very unique. And they have a lot of, like, bright neon colors. And I love them. Oh, yeah, Liz. He does like that, actually. Frank and him do the little, like, the balsa wood planes.
They do that, and they work on Legos a lot. He really likes building things. I think he's going to end up being an architect like his dad. I know that makes Frank cringe, but he really likes building things, and he really likes math. Like, I noticed as I'm working with him since I've become, like, sort of his teacher, he's much better at math than he is... than like English, like his letters and stuff like that. Praise the Lord, because I can always work with him on letters and reading and learning that way. I can't do math. I do basic math, and that's just about it. And thank God, because that's all that I need to do. I don't use math in my daily life, like in my work. So, holy Jesus. So at least Frank is good at math. He could work with him, but I just see Emilio has certain ways of Frank's that really make him, I think, lean toward being something like an engineer or an architect or something like that. I'm just reading your comments, that's why I'm quiet. I didn't leave you guys. What are you talking about, Robin? The Riley Sager book? I have not read her new one. I have so many review books to read, and I'm just trying to balance out reading the review books and the, like, my books that I really want to read, you know? So, I didn't even request it, because I have so much to read. I have the new, one of my favorite authors, and I can't think of his name now. Oh, gosh. Who wrote... I can't think of it, but I have, it's called The Dilemma, and that's coming out in July, and I have to read that, and I'm really excited to read it, and I've been holding out. It's one of my favorite authors, one of my favorite books. It's a thriller book, and I can't think of who it is. I apologize. And I have the new Catherine Center to read. I have, what's her name? Robin Harding's book, The Swap. I have a ton I can't even think of on there, and I have to read those, but I try to balance them out. Excuse me, I just burped on you guys. I'm so sorry. Because I'm drinking and trying to talk at the same time. I'm trying to balance them out with books that I really want to read, like my own pleasure books, and it's hard because you just have limited time and there's so much to do. Something that I've noticed, and this is like same on topic, but something I've noticed with people just from watching different people and what they do, like if you watch a colorist, do you notice that most colorists have more than just like two hobbies? Like, they have a lot of hobbies. I was watching, who was I watching? Oh, I was watching Shalene the other day. And Shalene has a lot of hobbies. So like, she has, let's see, she has reading, coloring, diamond painting, cross stitching, and planning. And I think maybe she might have something else. You guys would probably know better than I. And when you listen to people that have multiple hobbies like that, you learn about other people and channels on YouTube. So she was talking about somebody that, she also plays games. So, like, online games, like, The Sims and stuff. So, like, when you listen to people talk, they talk about other people that they watch with similar interests and hobbies that they do, right? So then you end up finding something that sounds interesting and you go over. So she was talking about a planner lady, that she was watching or whatever. So I was like, ooh. So not that I plan, and I'm not going to get into it because two hobbies is enough for me, but I find it so interesting how many people, especially the coloring people, have so many other hobbies besides just coloring. I don't know of anyone that has just one hobby. You know, and it could be much more than that, just like scrapbooking, reading, video games, like a lot of people do gaming. There's so many things, and there's so many things that you can learn from different people. But one thing that always strikes me about hobbyists is that, where do they keep all their crap, first of all? Where do you keep all your crap? Second of all, how do you afford all your crap? Because there's a lot of crap. When you have a hobby, there's a lot of crap. I don't care what hobby you have. If it's games, if it's crocheting, if it's coloring, if it's... What's this new hobby I've seen with these little peg things that you like iron and stuff? Do you know about those kinds of things? Your diamond painting. I have diamond painting. Oh, my dear Lord. I only did one so far, but I have a few of them. And when I say a few... I'm talking like five. That's max. And I haven't done anything with them in a while because I've not been into it. But if I ever do get back into it again, you know, I will. But I don't feel like the urge to buy them. I don't, like, when I watch people like Laura from Anxiety Art Adventures, when I watch her do her diamond painting and listen, I don't feel the urge to, like, do it. You know what I mean? Like, I don't. But when I watch, like, booktubers, certain booktubers, like I have two booktubers that constantly like influence me to buy stuff, and I watch them and I'm like, yeah, I need that. Or coloring, you know, I definitely feel the rub with the coloring and the reading, and I'm glad that it's just that for me, because I can't imagine trying to like shove any more stuff into this house. I can't. First of all, I'd have to get Frank to get another job. And then I would have to get another job. I suppose I could do more with my YouTube channel and, you know, try to make money that way so I could buy more crap. But I don't want to buy any more crap. I have so much crap and I don't need any more crap. But where does everyone keep their crap? I want to know, everyone, where do you keep your crap? Rock painting. That's a good one, Miranda. I've never done that. I don't think I watch anybody that does that. But that's interesting. You ask yourself that too, Shayna. Where do I keep my crap? I have no more room for my crap. I have a crap ton of books. I have so much coloring stuff. Like, it's out the wazoo. And I don't even have, like, half of a collection that other people do. Now, I will say this. I am not one of those people that buys a bunch of crap to buy it and then is like, oh, I don't want this. I don't like this. I don't do that. I buy what I really am interested in, and I keep it. And sometimes, like, I'll buy something, like my Crayola Super Tips. This is a perfect example. I bought them. I hardly use them. I saw someone else using them in something, and I think it was Dee Dee, and I was like, you know what? I'm going to try it again. That's why I don't get rid of my crap, because I always know with coloring, there's going to be a point where either I like something, or I don't like it at that time, and I'm like, you know what, I'm not going to do this. This isn't for me. But I usually, I think in 100% of the time, I've come back to it and said, I do want to do this now. I do want to learn this better. I do want to know. So that's why I don't understand. Like, a lot of times, I'll see people, like, getting rid of their stuff. Now, of course, there's always those times where you're just like, I can't use this. It doesn't work for me. I don't like it. That's it. And I never will. Like, you just get a really, like, bad place for it, right? But for the most part, I think a lot of us do come back to it and are like, you know what? I'm going to try this again and see how it goes. And then you get into it and then you learn how to use it better. And then, you know what happens? Then you want more crap. And I don't know why this happens. Zeely's so right. It's called hoarding. But here's the thing. I'm not going to try to say, like, I don't hoard. I definitely hoard. I am a big hoarder. For things like coloring and my reading, I hoard the stuff. And here's why. I don't know why, but I've noticed this about myself and other colorists. When you get a set of pencils, you just try them out. You say, oh my God, I love these pencils. You automatically want more. Anybody feel this or know why this is? Because it's the weirdest thing. It's like you find something, you love it, and instead of just keep using it, you want more to love. Does anyone else experience this? Or is it just me? Am I the only weirdo here that is just like, I want more stuff, I need it, I love this, I want more of it. It's so weird. I can't explain it, and I often will stop. Like, if I get a coloring book that I absolutely love, I'm like, oh, well, now I need to go buy all of those coloring books by that person.
But why? Why don't I just finish the one book that I started with that person? No. I need 5,500 others of all the other stuff. It's so weird. That's why you shouldn't get rid of your stuff, guys, because there's always going to come a time. I'm going to call this now for you. There's always going to come a time when you might buy something. You might be the only person to have it, right? But what will happen is someone that you watch on YouTube or you see on Instagram is going to also buy that. And they're going to, like, it's going to be like a Sammy or a Dee Dee or an Emily or a Passionista Colorista, one of these people. And they're gonna show you something, and they're gonna color this amazing freaking picture in it, and you're gonna go, oh, I want that book, I need that now. Even though you probably know you can't color like them, you're gonna get it. And then you're gonna buy 10 more. So keep your stuff, because if you don't and you get rid of your stuff, then you're just gonna have to buy it again. This is what happens. Now, I don't color amazing pictures, Mona. I just buy a lot of stuff, but that's it. And I keep my stuff because I know eventually someday I'm going to see something and say, I wish I still had that, so I don't get rid of it. I don't get rid of my stuff unless it's something like I absolutely hate or it's a piece of garbage. But I don't think I can say I ever have gotten rid of any of my coloring stuff. I have gotten a few coloring books that I did lose interest in, and I know that I wouldn't be interested in them again, only because I think over time, like your coloring, the way that you color and the things that you find appealing, I think change over time. But what I'm talking about is some of these books that are like Zen doodles and stuff like that. I don't like those. But when I first started coloring, that was like the thing that was really out there. It was like really right before Johanna Basford came out and really hit the scene with her different kinds of pictures and stuff. So it was more like that kind of thing. But for the most part, I keep everything. And that's right. It is a colorist logic, but it's weird. It's something in your head. Excuse me. It's something in your head that when you find something you like, you just want more of it. It's something with this coloring hobby, and it's the reason why so many people see something and then it starts going crazy. Everybody starts buying it and stuff like that, because it is just something about it. I wish I could put my finger on what that is or where that comes from, but it's a weird feeling that doesn't happen with everything for me. Like I said, with the diamond painting, I don't feel that, but it's something about the coloring that really makes me feel that way. And I do feel that way about books, but not to the degree I do about coloring. So weird, right? I know, right? Hoarding with pugs. I should change it. Just change it to Jen the Coloring Hoarder, because if I see it, I'm gonna buy it, most likely. So what could I tell you? I own it. It's me. This is me. And I'm putting it out there. Not afraid to say it. The only thing I won't do is I don't like throwing money away. Like you give something away or you don't like it and you throw it out when you've given it like a half a chance. And then you're like, oh, I want that again, and then buy it again. That I don't want to do. That's why I don't get rid of my stuff, because I just feel like you're just wasting your money at that point. But I do know that when I try something, if I'm not awesome at it, or it doesn't, like, in other words, tickle my pickle at that moment, at some time in the future, it's probably going to tickle my pickle. So I'm going to keep that, put it to the side, and come back to that when I feel like this is what I want to do at that time. You know, Angie, I don't do that. I don't stare at my pencil cases all the time, just because, well, for the most part, they're in my coloring cart, and that's been kind of like behind the couch, because I color mostly on the couch. But when all the stuff with COVID happened, I moved my coloring cart to the kitchen, because that was where I was spending most of my time. And so now I get to see them every day, and I have to admit, I love them. Do you guys want to see the new pencil case that I just got?
I just got it. It's the cutest freaking pencil case. It's like totally made for a 5-year-old. So automatically I wanted it. And I love it so much. You guys want to see it? I'm going to have to go down and get it. All right. Give me 1 second. Angie said I gave away a diamond painting last week and it felt like an intervention. I love you people. You guys are the best. All right. I'm going to get my pencil case. I'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. Okay, I'm back. I have my 5-year-old pencil case now. Ugh. Okay. All right. So, let me move Dobby out of the way for a second. Oh dear, I've actually gotten more coloring done on this stream than I've done in a long time, so I'm proud of myself. Okay, so here is my 5-year-old pencil case. Let me zoom it out. And I dropped one of my whole buttons on the floor, so let me get that. So, I had to have this because it's pink and it has unicorns on it. Or mermaids, or narwhals, things of that nature. Like, if you look at something and say, oh my god, a 5-year-old would love this, just know that Jen would love this. So then you should just order it and say, Jen would like that. No, I'm just totally kidding. But if you do see something for like a 5-year-old, yes, it's for me. So it's really cute. It's a little bit different than the usual, like the BTKSY ones that you have, but this one has like the little handle on the top, and then it has a little like zip pouch here, which I like because you can put whatever you want to do in there. I don't know. But let me see how I can do this. So this, I bought the 120 set of the Crayola pencils because I started using them in my color by numbers and I like them a lot. I have been having a lot of fun using these. Emilio and I are using them together. I had the 100 set and these were $25. So I was like, you know what, for 120 pencils that Emilio and I can both use, yeah, I'm gonna get them. So I got these. You can see they have beautiful colors. I think this fits 200. So, they have, like, really, really pretty colors. Like, especially this. I don't know if you can see this, like, this bluish purple, like, periwinkle color, but it is so pretty. It's got some really nice neon colors in them. These are, like, this Crayola stuff is great to work with if you just do layers. Just do light layers, and you're good with it. So, I have all of these in here, and then I bought these twistable pencils. Now, you might remember I had these years ago. They just came out with a big set of them. I think it's a set of 50. And I knew that I could fit them in here with the Crayola pencils. So Emilio and I also use these together. We've been using these in his workbooks. So if you guys want the link to this, if someone can't find it, one of the mods can't find it, I will find it and I'll put it in the description of the video, and if I forget, just ask me. So, hold on 1 second. So I bought these because we're using these together. These were incredibly inexpensive, like I think $12 for these little pencils. And
I just really like them. I've been also using those in the color by numbers, and they're fun to use. But Amelia and I, like, we use those together. I had these a long time ago, and I didn't give them up, but I did give them to Emilio, and he, when he was little, like two, when he was first started to color, and he just, like, he twisted them all up, he used them, he broke them, and I never replaced them, but when I saw them with a bigger set the other day and for cheaper, I really liked them, so I said, let me get those, and then I bought the crayon ones, too, and he absolutely loves those, so we're using those together as a kind of, like, little reward when we do his schoolwork, so, yeah. And another thing that I bought that I've really loved is this little Tombow Mono eraser. Can you guys see that? This thing is a really good little eraser. I bought the refills for it. It's very inexpensive. I think we got this at Blick at one of the last times that we went there. And it's a really good eraser, like much better than the Faber-Castell ones that I usually use. Let me see if I have any of those. Here I go. I always have to enable you people when I get here, but these are the ones I typically use, and I have to tell you, the Tombow one erases much better for all pencils. So if you're looking for a good eraser, this is a good one. And I bought one of these, too. I don't know. This is, I guess, what it's called? Taihu? Taihu, right? It's a mechanical eraser. It's so much better than the Derwent one. First of all, it's much easier to hold in your hand and push the button. The Derwent one was so bad. I dropped it twice. I broke it twice. I wasn't getting another one of those. This one, I think, was only like maybe $12 or $13 on Amazon. And it came with like 100 refills, and they're like different sizes because you can take the little piece out here and you can put all different kinds of ones in there. I really like this one if you have like a big area to erase, and I also find that this is better than the Faber-Castell ones. So I don't know if those just suck and I just never knew it, but I really like those two erasers. I definitely, if I had to pick one, I would definitely pick the Tombow one because it's so light, it's so easy. Like, you can just, even if you were just going to stick it in here, and it works on all pencils. So I highly recommend those. You have the Derwent one, Angie? I used to. Emilio dropped my first one, broke it. Frank replaced it. And then I got the second one. And I dropped it and it worked, but it doesn't work great, and it's so heavy, and I hate that about it, because when you have bad hands, it just doesn't go properly. But I'm going to show you guys, I brought it up since I had to go downstairs anyway, I'm going to show you this coloring book that I just got. Where did I get it? Like a week ago? I ordered it from Amazon. Somebody was asking me on Instagram about it because these books are hard to find right now, especially I was getting them on Amazon UK, and they don't really have very many of them anymore, and also they're not really shipping to the US. I don't order on Amazon Japan, but you could probably get them from there. I just don't order from there. But I really wanted this book because this book has a picture of Lotso in it, and he's one of my favorite characters. So, why can't I, like, okay. So, let me show you the picture that I did, and then I'll show you what the little, here he is. I'll show you what the little key looks like so you can see. So this book is really unique in that it has both the pixel kind, which I did these all with, I did two pencils. I did Polychromos on most of it, and then I actually found out that the Speer and Farbers work really good on this. So I think I'm going to use those from now on, but I used the Faber-Castells on this one for the most part, and it was really fun to do. The only problem with it is that you have to keep sharpening it to keep it sharp. But because this book is two-sided, I really can't use alcohol markers on it. And I'm kind of actually afraid. The paper is not that thick. I'm afraid that if I go too hard, I might go through it with my color, with the Crayola Super Tips. So I'm just looking to see what you guys are saying here. Um, Okay, Mona, just remind me about the, just remind me about the link, and I'll get it in there after the stream is over. The pencil wrap? You mean the pencil case? The unicorn one? Yes, I will find that. I don't have, I can't tell you at the moment, because I'm not, let me see if I can figure out. I could probably tell you, oh my gosh, the stream's almost over. I can probably tell you who the name of the maker is for the pencil case if you want. Just give me a second. Just give me 1 second and I can tell you. Sorry, guys. So what I was saying about this book in the meantime while I'm looking for the pencil case is that it has the swirls, like the circle ones, and it also has the pixel ones. So I did the Mickey with the pencils, and I think I'm going to continue on with the pencils in this book because I really like the way it came out. It was fun to do, and it was actually came out neater than when I did the other ones with the super tips. I noticed those come out a little bit wonky sometimes because the water kind of like moves in them and they come a little like streaked and stuff like that. Okay, this is called Pencil Case Holder Slot Holds 202 Colored Pencils. This is by Quan Shan. Here, let me see if I can write it in the chat. Oh, okay, Mona's got it. Never mind, she's on top of it. So, yeah, so anyway, I ordered this from Amazon, and here is, let's look at the key so you can see what the little pictures look like in here. And then, believe it or not, my friends, the stream will be over. But, yeah, so this is super cute. These are all, well, they're supposed to be babies, but not all of them are babies. But you can see, like, these are the circle ones, and these are the pixel ones, like the Mickey I just did. And I really, really wanted to do Lotso, so I ordered this. So that's what I've been working on. I'm going to continue working on Dobby, too, because I think he's coming out cute. But I'm really, really enjoying doing this. This is such a, like, such a fun thing to do, to just like relax. And I put on my Red Hot Chili Peppers and I just like rock out and work on my pictures, and it's super cute. So I did the Jen thing and I ordered 2 more books because that's what you do. And just as a tip for anyone that's interested in these books, they have a few of them on the Book Depository US, which you can order through Amazon if you're interested. So they only have a few, and I ordered 2 yesterday. I didn't order them through Amazon. I actually ordered them directly through the Book Depository. But I noticed that once I ordered them, they removed off Amazon. So I don't think they have a huge stock of them. So if you're interested in these kinds of books, these color by number, they do have a few of them, and you can hop on them real quick. You like the Red Hot Chili Peppers too, Angie? Yeah, Arteza does have them, Shara, and I do have one from Arteza as well, which I really like, but they don't have the pink unicorn one, so I had to have the pink unicorn one. I'll show you 1 second, Mona. So let me just, so this was the one I just did, and that was so much fun. And then here's Mr. Lotso. So now that I feel like good about the pencil usage, I'm gonna do Lotso in pencils because I want him to be perfect. And I feel like I have to match the colors perfectly. I wouldn't use like my Holbeins in this book or like a soft pencil because it's going to be incredibly hard to keep a point on them. I think a harder pencil would be perfect. So that's why I tried it with the Polychromos, and I really like the other ones that I was talking about, the Spira Farbers. And also, folks, I just noticed that they came out with a larger set, a 96 set of the Spira Farbens. So you can get a lot of colors in that, although it's a little pricey. I think it's like $47 or something like that for the... No, it's not. It's $69 for the 96 set, so... Yeah, but if you're looking for one of these books, look under, just type in like on your Amazon search this, Coloriages Mysteries, obviously that's in like
I think it's in French because this is from Hatchet Heroes. I'm pretty sure this is French, but they have these books in other languages like Spanish and stuff, so you can find them in other places. But this one is hard to find, and I paid a lot of money for it, but I really wanted this one. And it's a super thick book. There's a, you could see all the pictures there were doing it, so it's definitely worth the money. Well, I am so happy that I was able to hang out with you guys, and obviously I kept myself talking the entire time. I was worried I wouldn't be able to, but there you go. I just never stop talking. I'm so sorry, you guys. But before I go, I again want to thank Vicky. They are all sleeping because they're in the UK or they're in Europe, and it is definitely a lot later there than it is here. But I want to thank all the streamers. It's a pleasure to stream with all of the ladies, especially Emily. Thanks so much for coming by. I'm going to hang out at your stream. She's probably started already. So everyone go over to Emily Illustrator and go watch her if you're up for a while. I'm going to go over and see what she's up to and check out her Gryffindor nails. And thank you so much for hanging out with me. It's so good to see you guys. I'm going to have some videos coming for you this week. Like I told you, I have a big haul. I have new stuff to show you and some things from the artist. So it's going to be a lot of fun when I get those up, and we'll talk and we'll chat. And I've had so much fun tonight. Thank you so much. Thank you to my mods. And I look forward to the next stream. As long as they invite me, I love to hang out with you guys and I love to do this. So thank you so much, guys, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you, guys. Good night. Have a great night. Thank you for hanging out.